artificial intelligence and predictive modeling. And while we build this case, we're going to go through some of the details of what is needed and necessary to get to that particular level, number one. And we are also going to focus a little bit more about where artificial intelligence as a study has been very prevalent, how it has been applied in the different facets of healthcare, and you know, we're going to boil it down towards the end, how it can bring a lot of value within healthcare technology management, and which is something which is very dear and near to us. So with that said, you know, the next speaker is going to introduce himself.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Beautiful day to be alive. So I'm here from a clinical engineering perspective. I have a little bit over 30 years experience in the clinical engineering field. I did clinical engineering in the Air Force for 20 years. So I've been involved in every aspect of repair, purchasing, contracting, and disposal. So I'm here to speak to the clinical engineering side of this.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Rita D'Angelo, and I'm a diagnostic laboratory consultant, and I'm going to bring the perspective of diagnostic laboratory into the presentation.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Emma Kodapuri. I'm currently studying at Wright State University in biomedical engineering at Wright State University, and I will be going into my junior year this coming fall. So today we will be speaking to you about the process of how data analytics and artificial intelligence has been established within the healthcare industry. We'll also be addressing the essential steps that need to be taken prior to the construction of data analytics and AI within the healthcare technology management industry. Using these ideas, applications of data analytics and AI will be used to analyze possibilities of the process within healthcare technology management. So data analytics has a progression consisting of three different tiers, which consists of data, information, and knowledge. Data is the largest category containing raw, unorganized information that is factual and statistical. Information contains structured data, which means that the data is contextualized, categorized, calculated, as well as condensed. Lastly, knowledge converges this contextualized information to reach an understanding, insight, or decision. So the most important progression is the flow from data to information. Data must be standardized and optimized in order for it to be utilized for analysis. Data cannot be optimized if it is not standardized. Therefore, utilization is out of the question. And once data analysis reaches the stage of utilization, it can be applied in three different ways within the healthcare technology field, which is the application, acquisition, and management. The application aspect directly associates with clinical outcomes, while acquisition indirectly associates with clinical outcomes, focusing more on planning and project management. Lastly, management focuses on service, repair, and management of patient care, and is indirectly associated with clinical outcomes. And Dr. D'Angelo will